Hey, Peter Gregg here, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
All right, yesterday I did a video with Panasonic 6K mode on the GH5, and I did the whole thing. So yesterday's video was basically done with 5184x3456. All right. So today we're doing it in the 3:2 mode. No, not 3:2, it's 16:9. Now you cannot set that on the camera. You set that in your computer. So the video that this video eventually, when I get it edited, which you're seeing it already, so you're ahead of me, is going to come out at 5184x2916. Okay, so that'll be 16:9, which is what you're used to seeing on YouTube and on your television and in most other places. So I figured since I just did the one for the full resolution of the 6K photo mode, I'm going to do one and do it in the 16:9 so that you could see the difference. And then I guess I should also do one in the other one, which is the 4:3 mode, 4:3, and that's going to be 4992 by 3744. Okay. That will be the pixel size for the 4:3. Okay, so it sounds a little bit confusing, but it's not. Number one, you're used to using or seeing 16:9. So that's 16:9. Now what I did yesterday is I recorded the video in the 6K photo mode from the GH5. And I did it in 5184x3456. And I didn't crop it. In the middle of that video, I cropped it as to what the 16:9 would look like. But of course, I can't make it bigger in the middle, stretch it out to the end in the middle of a video. So in this one, I'm recording it in the same 5184x3456, but when I make my canvas or what the size appropriations are for the timeline in, I'm using Final Cut Pro, but you would do the same thing in whatever it is that you're using. I declare it at 5184x2996, which is 16:9. So if I didn't say I was shooting this in 6K photo mode to video, you wouldn't really know it, would you? But I am, and I'm uploading the full resolution of the 5184x2916. So that is what we're watching now. So this one looks normal. The one from yesterday had black bars on the side, and the one I'm going to do right after this is I'm going to do the other resolution, which is the 4:3 resolution, and that's 4992x3744. Of course, I could crop that one too, but I'm not. I'm going to leave that one so you can see what it is. Now, let's keep a couple of things in mind. Two things. The camera is not designed to be shot in 6K mode, but it happily does so. So why do they have that in there? Panasonic put in a 6K photo mode, meaning you can shoot in video at 30 frames per second. And then on the back of the LCD, it gives you all those frames. You pick out which one you want by going back and forth through them. You do it on the LCD on the back of the camera. And then you tap on it. And then it says, do you want this one? And you'll say, yes, I do. Then it'll say, do you really want this one? And I'll say, yes, I do. But the point is, it's not super quick and easy, okay? But it's there. And, the Sony A9 is a full-frame camera, and it shoots 20 frames per second in raw video. This one will shoot the video, so that means it can only come out as a JPEG, but you can extract 18 megapixel images from it. Now, there's some things that are not available because remember, Panasonic is not considering it to be a video item. I'm using it right now as a video just to show that, hey, you can shoot higher resolution for $2,000. You can shoot what they call 6K photo, but it's really pretty much a 5K. You take that up with Panasonic, okay, but that's the way they worded it. I haven't had any problems with it. I did get a lot of questions. My goodness gracious, how can something so out of the way create that many questions? You know, but what I did get was Jingle Bells Rocks, Jingle Bells Rocks, Jingle Bells Rocks. You know, you want me to go through these questions? I'm not going to do it now in 6K mode because these files are going to be gigabytes in size, okay? Another Jingle Bells Rocks. So you know what happens. For every Jingle Bells Rocks I get one of these, you know, pigs in a blanket type thing where it looks like a little hot dog rolled and that. And it smells kind of like pepperoni, and somebody didn't get a whiff of it yet. He's still laying over there. Can you see him? He's still laying over there on the couch. So, let's see. If I can remember some of the questions, just to shoot some off really. Jingle Bells Rocks. That's 142 Crisp wrote that. Let's see. There's, I see black bars on the left and on the right. Duh. Do you know why? Because on the video from yesterday, which these comments, all of these pages, like 14 pages of comments, the reason that there was black bars yesterday is because I did the full 5184 by 3456 and didn't trim it. So that's what it looks like. Now tomorrow, if you don't like black bars, make sure you skip tomorrow's video because I'm going to shoot the other one, 4992 by 3744. And it's going to be square. So if there was a little black on each side bothered you, you're going to get a lot of black on each one. And I'm not going to trim it down. Now today's, I trimmed it down properly. I trimmed it down to the 16:9 ratio, which is what you're used to seeing already. Go watch a YouTube. Go watch any of my older YouTubes. And they're all in conformation. They're conforming, English. They're conforming to the 16:9, just like everyone else does. Now, the one yesterday, I did not conform. I slapped up the original 6K photo stream because it records it in video. Now, here's a couple of questions. Can anybody see this in their computer if you recorded it in a GH5? The answer is no, mostly, all right? Now, when the GH5 is recording 4K video, I don't know if everybody realizes it, it's not shooting exactly 4K, it's actually shooting large. It's shooting the sensor. It's shooting the 5184, and it brings it down to 4K. Sony does the same thing. They shoot in 6K, but a bigger version of 6K than Panasonic's version of 6K, and they reduce it down to 4K. So technically, you get a better image that way. So the Canon C100 is a cinematic camera that most people don't know about, but it's a 1080p recording camera, but it records it at 4K in the sensor, but it never gives you access to that 4K stream. It brings it down to 1080 and then puts it on to the card, okay? The Sony cameras are doing the same thing. They're recording it at 6K and they bring it down to 4K and they record that on the card. The Panasonic GH5 records the 4K at 5 plus something K, 5.5K let's say, okay, just to round it out. All right, and then they bring it down to 4K and record that on the card, not this card, okay? They use the SD card. So now what Panasonic has done that's a little bit different is they introduced 4K photo. So the GH4 has a 4K photo mode, meaning that you shoot, you're actually recording video, and then everything pops up here that you just shot. And then you flip through it, you tap on that, and it makes it a JPEG. You flip some more, you find just the right one where everybody's eyes are open, or everybody's smiling, or everybody's looking at the camera, you tap, and it writes it to the JPEG. Writes a JPEG to the card. So it comes in handy and dandy. So now the GH5 is doing the same, but they upped it up a notch. They zipped it up. They went like Emerald, bam! And they took it from 4K and they put in something called 6K photo. So what does that do? When I do that in the G85 or the GX85 or the GH4, I go through it, I pick out that I want that shot, and it gives me an 8 megapixel shot, as if the camera had an 8 megapixel sensor in it, which is not bad. So don't think, oh, 8 megapixels, terrible, terrible. I shot entire weddings on the Canon 1D Mark II and the Canon 1D Mark IIn for a couple of years, and they were 8 megapixel cameras. So it's like, wow. And no, they were not full frame, but they were APS H, okay? So it was like a 1.3 crop. So now what Panasonic did is they're giving us 6K. So what's the added advantage between 4K and 6K? Well, instead of that image being an 8 megapixel image, it is an 18 megapixel image. Wow, you're talking almost like a full, it's actually more than what this camera can do, okay? So they really did something pretty nice with that. So here's where you get under the hood. It comes out with a file and you go like, hey, what can I do with that file? Well, they already gave us some information. That file is basically an H.265 file. It's not intended to be a movie file, but it's there and it's mine. I recorded it. So I put it in the computer, and lo and behold, it's there, but nothing can read it. So the file is a complete movie camera, and I got to put it back into the GH5 in order to see the files. Although Panasonic does give you some kind of a software, but it's like double, okay? And you can extract them there. So here's this software called Convert4 from HD Cinematics. All right, it's called Convert4. And now they've upped it, and it's called Dolly's Mustache. And that's a complete suite. So what does that do? It takes the file and allows you to scrub through it or look through it and press a button on your keyboard or the mouse, and it takes out the picture. So I started thinking, why can't I just record in 6K and get a 6K video? Well, I can, because the same people, HD Cinematics, is coming out with a new software, and I happen to have the pre-runner, the alpha and the beta, version. And what it does is it takes the 6K photo stream and converts it to what would you like? Would you like it to be a ProRes file? Would you like it to be an MJPEG, our favorite file? Would you like it to be an H.264 file? You get all these things. So on the Windows side, on the PC, you would use Dolly's Mustache or Convert4, whichever one you want to download. And it allows you to do a few frames, but it winds up being $25. That's the bottom line. And no, I don't get any of that money. If somebody says, oh my God, Peter, you're not making money with this, are you? God forbid you should make money, Peter. No, not you, everybody else, but not you. Don't worry. Chill. Cool your jets. I'm not making any money. What I do get is I get the program before you. And I still paid for it. So don't think, oh, I'm getting the program, the $25 program, and I made out like a bandit. No, I paid for it. Okay. So on the PC side, here, I'll write it down for you. Okay. On the PC side, It's going to be either one of two names. I'm not sure if Convert 4 is even still up there, but it's Convert 4. Okay, and the updated version to that is called Dolly's, and don't ask me, I have no idea why, Mustache. Okay, so this is for the PC. So what I was doing is playing with the 6K files and then taking them into my Windows computer and using Dolly's Mustache and converting them to ProRes. So the gentleman that runs this company that owns it got into some kind of a little accident. So I call him to say, hey, how are you doing? Are you okay? Because we worked quite closely together, because Dolly's Mustache and Convert 4 will also convert the GH5 422 10-bit files that sometimes you can read and sometimes you can't. I know that Premiere Pro upgraded the program so you can read the 422 10-bit 4K video in Premiere Pro right now, all right? But Vegas can't read that. So what you got to do is you got to transcode it. So you use Convert 4 or Dolly's Mustache. And lo and behold, it'll also convert, you got it, the 6K photo movie. And then we wind up with a 6K video. Wow, for $2,000? I'll take two, you know. But what if you're in the Mac side? Well, what's new, and as I was talking to him to find out how he was feeling, is what's new there is coming is called vMac. And that is coming for the PC. And this video was transcoded by that program in my hot new handy dandy iMac computer, which I promised you guys I was going to tell you about, but next video, or probably the next one after that. So vMac is coming, and it's coming, and you'll be able to find it at HD, high definition, HD, Cinematics. And just in case I misspelt it, I'll put a link to it on the bottom, okay? And I'll put a link to the GH5 so you can go look at it on our wonderful Amazon shopping experience. So that's what's going on. So now, whether you're on the iMac or on the PC, you'll be able to shoot 6K video. So one of the questions in here was, I don't remember the wording exactly, but it's like, why? Why bother? Okay. Well, the reason is when you shoot still pictures, a lot of people, including myself, want the master, which in our case is RAW. Okay. So we would shoot RAW, and the RAW never gets changed. And from there, you turn them into JPEGs or TIFFs or PSDs or whatever it is that you need, but you always will have that RAW file. Okay, so can you do that for videos? Well, yeah, they make video RAW also, but it's not something that we're going to afford. It's a lot bigger dollars, okay? Although the Canon C200 is coming out, and that's going to put it within reach of a lot of people. So by making a high-quality 6K photo movie and using it as a movie instead of as pictures, you're in effect creating a very high-quality master to work from. And from there, let's say like I'm putting it up on YouTube, if you notice when you click on the thing to see what's available, depending on what you're on, like if I'm on my iPhone or on my Android phone here, obviously it's going to be the most they feed it at is 1440. I was looking at it the other night and I clicked to see, oh, why is it running at 1080? So I'm going to move it up. So the highest I could go, even though I know it's a 6K photo stream thing, was 1440. Now, if I go into the desktop computer, it goes all the way up to what's called 5K, because they used to have 4K and 8K. Now they got 4K, 5K, 6K. I haven't seen the 7K, but maybe it's there for all I know, and an 8K. So depending on what time of day it is, how YouTube will feed it, it will tell you what's the highest resolution you can get. But be rest assured, this is going up as a 5184 by 2916 video file straight into YouTube. And then they're going to make all the little ones. They're going to make a 2K, they're going to make a 1080, they're going to make a 720. All those things are made off of the master file that I zip send up to YouTube. So I wish it really was zip. It takes quite a while to send these large files up. So I was going to get into the workflow of this, but let's do that for tomorrow, because I'm going to shoot the one that nobody's going to like, which is 4992 by 3744. I have it written over to the side there so I can remember the numbers. So this is it. What do we got going here? Okay, not bad. So let's get this up to YouTube. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you with the next one, which will have big, fat, black bars on the sides. This one's got none. This one's in 16 by 9. All right, that's it. Thanks for subscribing. I noticed there's a few new subscribers, so thank you and welcome to the family. Welcome to the Christmas room. All right, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.